Since the early 1900s, Cincinnati has been an area where great boxers emerged. From Ezzard Charles to Aaron the Hawk Pryor, growing up in poverty-stricken areas of Cincinnati has made them into sports icons. Millions of kids each year in the United States are trying to play sports, but the journey for many of these kids is encumbered by the financial struggles that they were born into. These kids have a much different path to the Friday night lights of high school football. For some, it's just a game, but for others, it's the only way out of poverty.
Carlos Delgadillo, and I'm a senior, Andrew P. Hill. You're coming from like so-called ghetto. You hardly have like any privilege there, so like the most times you do is just play soccer.
From their opinion, the only way they're going to succeed in life is to use sports to get out of the situation that they're in. So they take it very seriously, they're very competitive about it, and try and take care of themselves as well as they can. And then you
have obviously for child care, they kind of help their parents out when it comes to child care, whether it's watching them after school, taking them back and forth. A lot of them have part-time jobs to help support their families. So there's going to be days where they can't come to practice because they have a job, and it's hard for us as coaches to demand that kind of accountability when you know that the kid's not missing because he wants to. He's missing because he has to have that job to help his family put food on the table, and all he's doing is trying to help out.
I started playing soccer at the age of 10. Coming from a background of Latino, basically your both parents are working, and with siblings you always have to be taking care of them. But joining the Anza Force, I basically started getting serious about colleges and stuff because I didn't know what I was going to do. And it was basically last year of August.
I would like to see, them grow up in Project Housing Authorities, being racially profiled growing up, sometimes not even having nothing to eat. Sometimes having to wear the same damn clothes to school for a whole week, and then all of a sudden, a big ass change in their life, like they dream come true.
More like they decide that it dedicates itself more. Like with the richer, you just like have everything you want, so you basically don't decide what to do with it.
There are some severe differences. For example, when I walked into the athletic training room here, my first thought was, oh my goodness, this is humongous. I've never seen a high school athletic training room this big.
Football budget is upwards of $45,000 or $50,000 a year, and it pretty much buys us anything I want.
I do think that those that are live in less fortunate areas because of the fact that that's all they have, and then that's all they can do, like sort of like an escape. And those who have everything, they just use it as sort of like a hobby to just look good in college applications and stuff like that.
But both coming from my high school, which was Sequoia, which I'd say middle to low income, and Stagg High School, which is very low income, and even things like having an ice machine as nice as the one that we have, having one that's large, having more than one treatment table, more than one taping table, having enough supplies to actually do things.
Over there for football might be $3,000, and I think that's what it was at Evergreen, and that's it for the year. You can't buy a lot with $3,000. I mean, your helmets are $275 a piece, your shoulder pads are $200, and you get $3,000 a year, and you have to find a way to make that happen, and that includes whether you want to buy uniforms or not too for your players. Over there, most of those schools don't sell their jerseys to their players. The school has to buy them and keep them because the kids can't afford to buy the jersey. So you have to find a way to fundraise as best you can to support that. You know, you just can't go down and just buy footballs. You have to really acquisition every year on how many footballs am I going to buy this year? Do I need something big? I mean, all those schools have booster clubs too, but all those programs have needs.
Because I've never had that, like, support of a parent because they're always working, so, like, I'm basically on my own, but no.
The ability to participate in athletic activities is a privilege often taken for granted. Many kids in impoverished areas may not even be able to discover their talents due to lack of opportunity. Our school and students needs to create a more widely available athletic option and appreciate the opportunities that they have been given.
Talking though. Well, come on, boy, it's automatic. It's automatic every time. Check it out.